Can a tuna save the dolphins? Hi, and welcome to the Daily Sports Update presented by Toyota here on CBSSports.com. I'm Amber Wilson. Wednesday was a very busy day for Bill Parcells. It started with rumors of the two-time Super Bowl champion coach who left the Cowboys after the 2006 season, taking a vice president of football operations job with the Atlanta Falcons. And the day ended with reports of him signing on for the same position with the 1-13 Miami Dolphins. With rumors of Dolphins owner Wayne Huizenga looking to sell the team, the Dolphins went out last Sunday and picked up their first victory of the season over the Ravens. Now, under the shadow of the Parcells story, the Dolphins look to pick up their second victory against the undefeated New England Patriots up in Foxborough. A win for Miami, however unlikely, though, would maintain the Dolphins' 72 team as the only squad to go undefeated. The Boston Celtics, they're not trying to go undefeated, but at 20-2, they are an early favorite to come out of the East. Wednesday night, the team that has been the favorite for the past several years came into Boston in what could be an Eastern Conference Finals preview. The Pistons have appeared in the Eastern Conference Finals each of the last six seasons. And the Big Three fell to arguably the best starting five in the league. Chauncey Billups drew a foul with 0.1 seconds in the game with a tie score. He then strolled to the line, knocked down a pair of free throws to edge the team that originally drafted him back in 1997. He finished with a game-high 28 points and 8 assists. The Pistons won for the fifth time in their last six games, sending Boston to its first home loss. Kevin Garnett and Ray Allen both had big nights, but Paul Pierce struggled and missed a jumper with less than 2 seconds left that left the door open for Billups. Out in Dallas, best friends Dirk Nowitzki and Steve Nash put on quite a show as the Mavs held on to defeat the Suns 108-105. Dirk scored the final 8 points for Dallas and 31 on the night. The Mavs led for most of the way. They were up 14 with just 7 minutes to go. But behind Steve Nash's 21-point, 18-assist night, the Suns got to within three. But Nash couldn't tie the game from behind the arc as time ran out. Over in San Antonio, the Spurs have dropped two of their last three games since the return of Tim Duncan from ankle and knee injuries. All three of those games were played without All-Star point guard Tony Parker. Parker has been suffering from an ankle injury, but has also been suffering in the tabloids as well. He hasn't played since a celebrity gossip website published a story that he had an affair with a French model. Wednesday, Parker fired back, suing the website for the false and defamatory stories and will seek $40 million in damages. Oft-outspoken Boston Red Sox hurler Curt Schilling has wasted a little time to chime in on seven-time Cy Young Award winner and mentor Roger Clemens. Wednesday on his blog, Schilling called for Clemens to give up four of the awards if he failed to clear his name from the allegations in the Mitchell report. Schilling was among those who testified back in March of 2005 to a House committee investigating steroids. Kansas head coach Mark Mangino named the college football head coach of the year on Wednesday after a brilliant 2007 season that saw the Jayhawks come out of obscurity and challenge for a national championship. KU won a school record 11 games and came within a loss to Missouri for playing for a Big 12 championship and a trip to the BCS title game. Instead, the Jayhawks will have to settle for a trip to Miami and a date with Virginia Tech in the Orange Bowl. Speaking of which, tonight kicks off bowl season for the 2007 Poinsettia Bowl from San Diego. Navy, the number 8 scoring offense, takes on the number 3 scoring defense in the country in Utah. For more on all of your bowls, keep your mouse right here. CBSSports.com. I'm Amber Wilson. Have a great day.